Hey guys and girls, welcome back to the channel. Headed down here, I'm going to do a little series. Or not really a series, it's going to be a bunch of different segments in one video. So you may see change in the weather and the greenery and everything, the snow. So, but I just want to do a little video on spring water. You know, we all remember back a handful of years ago, the Flint, Michigan debacle, where they had lead in their water, and the city knew about it and tried to cover it up and everything. There's actually a movie made on that. It's actually a pretty good movie. I think it's just called Flint. If you can find that movie and watch it, it's actually pretty good, pretty informational. But do you have backup water sources that you can get other water if you would happen to get bad water, you know, in your town water, or even in your well, if, you know, something would happen, a chemical spill or something that would ruin your water? Do you have secondary resources that you can go to find more water? So that's what this video is going to be about. Take a couple different shoots to get everything in that I want to get in. I'm headed to one of the springs right now. I've gotten water from this. I've been drinking spring water most of the summer after the Rona started, pretty much. Just because I don't want the fluoride and all that other crap that we get in our town water. Mama EMT and even Little Helper's been drinking spring water more and more. They aren't 100% to it. I pretty much am. I make my coffee with it. I make tea and whatever else with it. So this spring down here is pretty popular. You may see quite a few cars. You'll see pickups and trucks with trailers. They'll have septic tanks on the back of them. And obviously clean new septic tanks that they fill up. They fill up and take home to their cisterns and whatnot and fill them up that way. Yeah, they have to, there's a pipe coming out. It's probably 5 feet tall or 5 feet high off the roadway, and they have to hook onto it with a fern co. There you can see the water coming out. I'm not gonna name this spring. People local to me might know what it is, but this is probably the most popular spring that I'm going to show you in this video, that I have around me at least. So I don't want to name it because I don't want to, one, locate my, you know, give my location to the world, and you know, two, I don't want the masses to just fall upon that spring as more so than it already is. Like I said, it is a pretty popular spring anyway. And I've had to wait just to fill up a few gallon jugs for a while. So with that, I'm gonna close this segment of the video and head to the next spring. I'm not sure when that will be. So actually, I'm headed to the hunting shack. Oops, sorry about my finger. Actually, I'm headed to the hunting shack, so there's another spring on the way that I've also utilized there. I'll show you that on the way. So I'll be back with you here in a few minutes. Okay, guys. Here's another spring I just found by accident the other day while I was hunting. It's over near where I'm hunting. Actually brought some empty jugs we had and filled up out of the spring. I haven't got to drink it yet. But I have seen a lot of other people, well, I can't say a lot, a few other people filling up out of this spring. So evidently it's good water. Obviously you're not going to fill a truck up out of that spring. It's not real high. I had a hard enough time getting a gallon jug underneath that spout. But, so this is another option I have if we would get bad water in our town, municipal water or something. So probably not going to get to another spring here in the next few days. I go back to work. There's another spring on the way to one of the stations that I work at. that I'll film. And then there's also a few springs that used to be near where I live that somebody closed down. I'm not sure why or who or whatever, but they used to be good springs, good popular springs also, and someone closed them down, so pulled them out and whatever you do to a spring to close it. So, all right, I got a few hours left of the day to go hunting. That's what I'm gonna do. See you in the next segment. Hey guys and girls, this is the spring that's on my way to the one station that I work at quite regularly. It's obviously on private property, you see on the sign there. So if you want to respect the landowner's wishes, because they don't have to share their water from their springs and pipe it out to a public access point. They could just let it run down the ground and run as runoff. So I have used this water. It's actually really good water. I'm actually still on vacation during hunting season. This is the second Sunday of season. Last Sunday was our first time that we could hunt on a Sunday in Pennsylvania. This is the second Sunday during season, which is closed to hunting. So I'm still on vacation. I'm not working. However, I'm down in this area because my one supervisor at work, his family loves to hunt the game. They don't like to eat it. So he called me and told me he had a doe for me. So I'm coming down to pick it up. He's given me deer before that they have harvested. They give their deer away to everyone, to other people every year. I always tell him every year that if he knows of a family that actually needs the meat, to please give it to those that may be less fortunate. We don't actually need the meat. We just want it, if that makes sense. So I'd much rather him help out a more needy family that could use a little bit of help in filling the freezer for the family. So this is the next clip in this video on spring water. Supplement or back up your survival plans if you would happen to have something happen to your home water system, be it municipal water supply or your own private groundwater supply. So I'm going to close this clip and we'll see you on the next clip. All right, the next segment of my spring water series. This spring here is one of the springs I was talking about that has been closed. It's quite the attractive spring, if you don't say. It's called the Ebenezer Spring. I'll put a still photo in right now. Didn't the spring look like it was quite the place to gather back in the day? Everybody at the office meets at their water coolers and coffee machines to chit-chat and everything at work and at the office. Well, this spring was quite the place to gather, evidently. I'm not exactly sure when the spring was shut down. I remember getting just a jug here and there, probably the mid-90s or so. So this is the one spring that's closed down, and I'm gonna head to the next spring that's been closed down, which is actually the closest spring to my house. All right guys, we're en route to the final stop here for this series in my backup water supply sources. This final spring is right along this highway, so I'm probably not going to be able to stop, but I will slow down the best that I can so you can see what's left of it. It wasn't too awful long ago, maybe 10-15 years ago, it was still active. A local Eagle Scout, fixed the spring up, made it look nice for his Eagle Scout project. And then it seemed like maybe a year or two after that, the spring was out of service. This spring, just like the Ebenezer spring that we just came from, I'm not sure why they closed those springs down. The only thing that's left in this spring that you could tell that it was a spring is the catch basin to drain the water away from the highway. I'll try to slow down the best that I can so you can see it. It's coming up on the left just after this lane here where the pickup truck is. So right there. So the spring was only maybe 4 miles from my house, if that. And sorry about that, I can't shift drive and talk at the same time. This spring's maybe 3 or 4 miles from my house. I've never utilized that spring at that time, you know, when it was in service, but so I'm going to end this series, put my concentration back on driving with all four hands, and I'd just kind of like to know what your plans are if you would happen to, you know, get some bad water in your water system, whether it's, you know, your own private groundwater or like some, you know, an instance in like Flint, Michigan. I don't even think that they can still drink their town water, but I'm not real certain on it. I kind of stopped following that situation. I might look into it here just for my own curiosity. So that's kind of like to know what you guys' plans are for backup water sources, if your personal water supply, what it may be, what happened to go bad. In the instance of Flint water, Flint, Michigan's water, you know, all the stores ran out of bottled water, like, real fast, and they price gouged it and everything, so, you know, it's not a bad idea to look for backup sources of water if you should need it. I think I said earlier in the video that my family's been drinking the spring water regularly now. Saves our town water bill. Plus, we're not getting all the fluoride and chlorine and all that crap into our systems as well. We just use our town water for more or less washing and sewage flushing and everything. So, with that, I'm going to close this video. This is EMT Railfan. I'm out of here.